Hi, and welcome to part four of my Balkans road trip. We are going to head into Bosnia Herzegovina, a country I love. But first, we're going to check out Zadar, the oldest continuously inhabited city in Croatia. Zadar is in the northern Dalmatian region on the Adriatic Sea. There's the mainland portion of the town, and then there's the peninsula portion of the town. I stayed at an apartment on the mainland and walked into the old town portion, which is located on the peninsula. It was a beautiful day when I went out exploring, and I loved the old town. This old town area on the peninsula dates from the 9th century BC when it was called Yadera. It became Roman in the 1st century BC and was a thriving cultural, artistic, and commercial center of Byzantine Dalmatia. Between 1045 and 1358, the town was at war with Venice on and off, and in 1409 it was sold to Venice. Was actually possessed by a few different countries over the years. Austria from 1797 to 1918, with a brief interlude from 1806 to 1830 when France had possession of it. In 1920, it became Italian, and at the end of World War II, it became part of Yugoslavia. Because it faced Ottoman attacks in the 16th and 17th centuries, it was also the most heavily fortified town on the Adriatic until the late 1800s. Also in the 1800s, Zadar produced 33 different types of liqueurs, the most famous being maraschino. During World War II, it was heavily bombed by Allies, which destroyed 75% of the buildings and port facilities. I had no agenda for Zadar. All I wanted to do was walk around and explore. If you take a walk along the beautiful coastline, which you should, you'll come across a unique musical section on the walkway called the Sea Organ. 35 pipes of various lengths, diameters, and slopes have been installed into these 7 stone stairs that extend about 70 meters along the waterfront. It's a unique sound. You have snow-covered mountains right there, and then here, sunny blue sea. This was called the Pillar of Shame. I think they would tie people against this pole and publicly shame them. I don't know why else it would be called the Pillar of Shame. Thank you. The weather was starting to get cold again, and I was losing steam. I popped into a small, quiet, and most importantly, warm DM to get an umbrella. Well, over an hour later, after looking at different face creams, I came out with a little bag of goodies that I really didn't need, but I felt thoroughly satisfied. When I think of Zadar, I don't think of the beautiful water, the historic buildings. I literally think of the contentedness and satisfaction I felt putzing around that little DM. Isn't it funny how those little, seemingly insignificant moments are sometimes the ones that can stick with us the most? This city has such a rich history, and it's really interesting to see the contrast between the old historic buildings and these buildings.
Some depressed buildings back there. There's a crab.
A few observations I made about Croatia before we head into Bosnia. One, cats. I forgot from the last time I was there 10 years ago, but Croatia is full of cats.
Hi, meow meow. Aww. Hi, Oitin. Yeah.
Okay, now she's really following me.
Hi, cutie. Are you following me? I don't have anything for you. I'm sorry. Miss sweetie.
Another thing I noticed, every time I walked around a town or drove into a new town, it was all men. So many men. The men seemed to outnumber the women significantly, and I kept wondering where all the women were. And lastly, this may be controversial, but I can't help it. This is how I felt last time, and I felt it again this time. I feel no connection to Croatia at all. I can't tell you how many people told me I should go to Croatia and how great it is. Even though we had road tripped extensively around Croatia the first time I went, I quietly kept the feeling to myself when people would rave about Croatia. I thought maybe I would feel differently now that I'm older, but I experienced the same feeling as last time. No connection. There's nothing wrong with Croatia. It's definitely a beautiful country. I guess it's just not my cup of tea. Okay, moving on to a country that is my cup of tea, Bosnia and Herzegovina. I will say I really knew nothing about the country before I went there. Actually, I really knew nothing about any of the places I went to because the only research I did was to make sure each place was safe. Beyond that, I didn't want to read or watch anything about these places because I didn't want any preconceived notions formed in my mind. I wanted to go in with an open mind and come to my own conclusions. So, when I got into Bosnia and Herzegovina, I was surprised in the best way possible. This country is wonderful.
Wow, look at that. Okay, I'm like already loving Bosnia. Except I don't know what the speed limit is anywhere.
I took the toll roads there and passed through many tunnels. They all had these bear and wolf crossing signs on them. Once I was off the toll road, the map was taking me on all these quiet, winding roads through weird little towns.
What? Oh, jeez.
I was trying to film these abandoned buildings, but I had to quickly throw my camera down because a car with a siren was coming toward me, followed by a huge military convoy.
Okay, this is supposedly taking me to the border. I've passed lots of pig, like wild boar pig crossing signs. This is kind of windy, narrow road.
They weren't even towns I was passing through. They were just like random groupings of houses.
So to the side. I'm not really sure what I'm filming right now because I can't look at my phone, but just wanted to give you an idea of the road. It's taking me from Croatia into Bosnia. Here. Road barely fits two cars. Wow, this is a larger town, if that's what you call these. One of the towns I just passed through on this like marshland, they had a tourist information for a photo safari. And you can take like a weird swamp boat and go around these marshes and take a photo safari. And the people that do the tour are dressed in like pirate gear. I just saw like a billboard for it. I didn't actually see the people, but so apparently a tourist come through here. I don't know. I think maps.me is like taking me to some really small border crossing. I don't know. This seems like there's not really anything around. People just like do this kind of stuff, get out, stop in the middle of nowhere. I'm like really close to the border, so I think this is it up here.
I crossed over the border in Metkovic and it was easy. I just showed them my passport and they asked if I had any cigarettes or alcohol with me. Then they made me pull over and very briefly and not thoroughly checked my trunks and bags. The officer was friendly and easygoing, though.
I'm in Bosnia!
Not so fast. I think that was more of an exit point out of Croatia because I drove a little bit farther before hitting what looked like a corrugated metal booth. The officer swiped my passport and nodded to me, and then I was in Bosnia.
Okay, now I just entered Bosnia.
Not so fast. I technically entered Herzegovina. But for brevity's sake, I'm just going to refer to the country as Bosnia. Before we get into all the sights of Bosnia, let's talk a little bit about why this one country has two names. Well, it is one country, but the name refers to the different regions of the country. This larger portion is Bosnia, and this region is Herzegovina. There's also two politically autonomous regions, the Republika Srpska, I have no clue how to pronounce that, and the Federation of Bosnia and Herzegovina. It's a multi-ethnic, multi-religious country comprised of Bosniaks, Serbs, and Croats, and their corresponding religions, Islam, Eastern Orthodox, and Roman Catholic. As we'll see and talk about in future videos, having these different groups led to a tragic war that you can still see the scars of all over the country. So, with that introduction to Bosnia and Herzegovina, we are going to save Mostar for the next episode. I loved, loved, loved Mostar, and you will too, so hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you know when it comes out. See you next time!